What's up?
We're trying to figure out the shock angle and location. That's really the last thing we have to do is get the shocks on here.
About a week ago, I got a call about this 92 Chevy C3500 known as the Krew Kut. Good thing the monkeys knew what it was, because I sure as hell thought it was just a dusty, dirty old truck. Turns out it's this legendary long-lost magazine truck from the 1990s. So we got it back to the garage, and I gave the monkeys 3 weeks to bring it back to life. They were about a week into the build when I dropped a bomb on them.
LST's coming up. That's the big truck show. That's the shit.
What's that, 3.5 weeks out, maybe?
No, 1.5.
Now they have a week less than they thought they did to get it all finished, so we can debut it at LST, a big truck show down in Conroe, Texas.
All right, well, so I guess I got it.
Yeah, we got it under control.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, that's what this truck does.
That way we don't scratch it up either.
It's built to drag.
Okay. It's pretty damn close. We're attaching the engine and tranny together so we can set the whole thing on the motor mounts to see how it fits in the firewall that Jeremy and I built together. The biggest mod so far is replacing the leaf springs with a four-link rear suspension. A four-link is basically just four bars. They're links that connect the frame to the rear axle and keep the rear end in place. And we added coilovers for a smooth ride. So I think we hit all the spots that really need to be addressed with the fabrication.
You good?
Yes. Yeah, come on.
Your hands.
Come on.
Just straight. You're in almost as far as you need to go if you just bring
it
up.
Yeah, that's better.
That's a lot better.
Fits really well.
Mm-hmm. Dude, this thing's... It's gonna be a monster in here.
I think we get this thing to paint and we'll be sitting pretty good. Look how well it fits in the firewall.
Well, it's because of the way we made it.
Yeah, it's like we thought 10 steps ahead.
Paint guns. More than anything, the Krew Kut is known for its flame paint job. So we want to keep that. It just needs a little touch up and a lot of love.
Pretty bad.
The bumpers, they're another story. Tony did his bodywork magic, but now I have to match the original color, which is called lime top. I got lucky and was able to track down the old formula. All I have to do is mix it up and shoot those bumpers.
Where'd you get it down at?
Thought you were trying to lose some weight.
Well, just a little bit.
Whoa.
I hate you.
Right.
Everything for Krew Kut that we need is in the booth and ready to paint. I got the lime time, and that's the color it's supposed to be, so it should match like a dream.
Wait a minute, this ain't right.
So I'm in the middle of spraying when I get this funny feeling. It's not looking like it should. Tony brings the cowl panel in, and it's still got all the original paint on it, and it's an easy part that's off the car already.
It's different.
Well, yeah, you barely just dusted it.
Yeah, but look how much lime, more lime it is. It's not so yellow.
Yeah. Look at it after two. Hit that next one a little bit heavier.
Tony thinks the more coats I put on that it's going to start to match, but I don't think that's the case.
There's no way it's not gonna get there.
I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's just because it's fresh. And the paint is the most iconic feature of the Krew Kut. And if I can't get the green to match, it's gonna be a problem.
Either they've
changed the formula.
Or it could have faded from the sun, which is super common. There's all kinds of things that could go on here. We're just gonna have to figure out what it is.
The formulas have changed. The material they use to mix paint has changed.
Yeah, everything
changes tones of everything.
EPA gets in everybody's business, mm-hmm. and they have to change it.
More water-based than oil, and that changes the tones. And
so we can run the cowl panel over to the paint store and have them run a color eye on it and see if they can...
Have a camera on top of it?
Yep. And we can change, get close to something else.
Send Chad.
We'll send Chad to the paint supplier to do a color match on the green, then do some spray outs to see what works. The thing is, we're gonna have to figure it out.
I'll go grab him, get him started on that.
And I'll keep messing with this. I'm confident that we can eventually get this green right. I just don't know if that will be in time for LST.
That sucks.
This is coming out good. Is the whole truck gonna come out this good?
We're working on it.
That's the goal.
We're working on it. We're having an issue right now with...
Well, I can tell you right now, that don't match that.
Well,
it should.
That actually does
These
match
These are
that.
Both original.
What does it match?
The fenders and
grill
bumper and
bumper.
Well, that don't match. I have a pretty good eye.
We're aware of this.
That is definitely not the right color.
Fuck, man. I know the color's off.
This is the original color.
Well, this is wrong.
I just got off the phone with the guy that actually painted the truck.
Okay.
It's lime time over gray. We did it over white. The problem is it was painted 20 years ago. So the formula's changed in the past 20 years.
That truck was painted 20 years ago?
20 years ago.
Holy cow.
Just life and fading, so we're just gonna have to tint on our original color and see if we can't get to that. So we're not gonna be able to just grab a can off the shelf and it work, which is what we were trying to do.
All right, so bottom line is, can you make it match?
I can try. It's gonna take time. We're gonna have to do spray outs. We're gonna have to tweak and test stuff.
Well, you don't have to go home tonight.
Hey, you're the painter. I just do bodywork, bro.
Here's the thing with the Resurrection. We gotta keep all of the minute details of this truck intact as it was, or we'll become the laughingstock of the entire trucking community, which is all of Texas. Just get it done, man. It's gotta match. No half-ass.
Ooh, look at that.
That's pretty sweet.
So you got these caps.
They say Krew Kut on them.
Yeah, that's cap. Awesome.
Oh, hell yeah.
Get out. We're days away from the LST show, and the guys actually have us ahead of schedule for once. This thing's really coming together, and we're about to start the final assembly.
That is super rad.
I mean, I say we, but I really mean them.
You killed it. So hopefully if these guys get the truck done, we'll make it to the show. Don't take up too much of their time. Get on it, fellas.
Krewed Kut.
If you're wondering why we didn't keep the original wheels, our hands were forced. When we got the Krew Kut, a couple of them were gone, and the wheels didn't all match.
Bling bling.
Current off-the-shelf rims would just not have the right look. But these custom rims, well, they really fit the look of the truck.
Oh, what a feeling.
I cannot wait to see people's faces when they see this baby at LST.
We're so close, guys. We're so close.
We've been working most of this week to get the engine ready to fire.
And it's gonna drink it up.
This baby's got over 600 horsepower, so hearing it fire up is not gonna just sound good, it's gonna feel good, knowing we're that much closer to bringing it back to life.
Jason, I'm about to fire this.
This is exciting.
It's a moment of truth, boys.
That exhaust sounds pretty good.
Like it. Hey. For a first test, that's awesome.
I didn't hear no exhaust leaks.
See anything leaking?
No, that's so what good. We were all celebrating.
Yeah, I was outside. I heard it running. It sounds good.
Did I hear this thing running?
Yeah, you did.
Rad.
It's pretty impressive, too.
You want to hear it?
Well, yeah. It's the only time I get to come out here and have fun is when something's working.
Watch your
Everybody's
eyes.
Everybody's heading hands out of the way.
It's got stage fright. Yeah, it's jumping.
What's that clacking?
That belt's misaligned.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, quick belt alignment, piece of cake.
I'm cool with that. So when are we gonna get on the road?
Easy, Tiger. A couple of tiny things and we're ready.
So let's talk about the 90s. I mean, grunge music was going strong. The dial-up interwebs were pretty new and things were changing fast. And I was finally out of high school. And the trucking community was building some crazy stuff. Come 1999, everybody was afraid of Y2K, how we avoid the apocalypse. Well, MIC and a guy named Sean had the right idea. Whack the top off of it, because you can jump and run. They called it the Krew Kut.
Hey, Richard, this is Donna. Sean Mahaney's wife.
Hey, Miss Donna, how are you?
My name is Donna Mahaney. I'm wife of Sean Mahaney, the original builder of Krew Kut.
I thought that this was a fitting tribute to Sean.
Late last year in September, Sean was killed on his way to a charity motorcycle ride, but he left behind a huge legacy of things that had been done. A whole new generation of mini truckers is going to be born from this. You know that, right?
This is not quite classified as a mini truck.
Yeah. Sean's soul is in that truck. He had a ton of fun building this truck because he did exactly how he wanted to do it, with hydraulics, with everything that was his specialty. You know, he made sure that truck was a great thing when it was done, not just, you know, another built truck. Thank you, guys.
Yeah. Well, go give him a hug.
Which, who do I hug first?